He was the greatest racehorse of all time, Secretariat, and his remarkable story is drawing box office crowds to the movie about his life, a movie starring Diane Lane. But it may shock you to hear what we've learned about one of Secretariat's direct descendants. Lisa Guerrero has our I Squad investigation, which we should warn you may have images that are unsettling.
This majestic thoroughbred has the blood of a legendary champion running through his veins. His name is Freedom's Flight, and he's the great-great-grandson of the most renowned racehorse of all time, Secretariat. The famed stallion galloped his way into the record books and is now the subject of a new Disney movie starring Diane Lane.
All right, then. Let's show him what you're made of.
Today, Freedom's Flight bears a startling resemblance to the noble Secretariat. But not too long ago, he looked like this. It's almost impossible to believe that this emaciated horse with protruding bones and open sores is a direct descendant of Secretariat.
He was in the worst off condition that I've ever seen a horse in my life.
Richard Kudo is an activist who runs the Animal Recovery Mission in Miami. He believes Freedom's Flight was about to be butchered alive.
He was basically up for slaughter.
This video, obtained by Inside Edition, was taken during a police raid where Freedom's Flight was found tied to a tree and clinging to life at what Kudo claims was an illegal slaughter farm in South Florida. Freedom's Flight's regal bloodline to Secretariat was discovered when Kudo noticed this unique tattoo across the horse's upper lip, which identified him as a thoroughbred. That tattoo also allowed him to learn of the horse's history.
They're off.
This is Freedom's Flight's last race in April 2008.
Turning for home here, Freedom's Flight.
What's not evident in the video is that Freedom's Flight actually breaks his leg right out of the gate. Amazingly, in a display of sheer guts that would make the great Secretariat proud, he still finished third.
Then came Freedom's Flight.
But he was unable to ever race again and was sold several times before Kudo says he ended up at death's door. The owner of the ranch where Freedom's Flight was discovered denies that he slaughters horses and has not been charged with animal cruelty.
So how do million-dollar thoroughbreds go from the glamorous world of horse racing to the grisly confines of an illegal slaughterhouse where they're butchered alive for their meat?
When racehorses can no longer compete, some thoroughbreds end up being slaughtered, their meat sold for profit on the black market. Kudo calls this thoroughbred racing's dirty little secret.
It happens every week, unwanted, injured, whatever the reason. If they can't perform on the track, they go to the illegal slaughter farms. The way they're butchering these horses, many times they'll just go up to a horse, take him by the halter, plunge a knife under his throat.
Horse meat is considered a delicacy in Europe, South America, and also in parts of Florida. This is a dish of horse meat made from the Mustang breed that's often displayed in European butcher shops. In most of the U.S., eating horse meat is considered taboo, and killing horses for human consumption is illegal. But Kudo says dozens of thoroughbreds are still being slaughtered every month in South Florida.
So they're literally killed alive and butchered alive for their meat.
Kudo took us to a field just off the Florida Turnpike, not far from where he shot this grim video showing horse skulls and bones strewn about.
This is death row for horses.
I would say within the next 2 weeks, every single horse that you see in this field will be on someone's dinner table.
But at least Secretariat's progeny is alive to run another day.
Kudo now keeps Freedom's Flight in a secret location because he says there have been death threats directed against him and the horse.